Alright, so got my pot all warmed up. Add some olive oil. About a half a cup or so. I'm going to add my ground venison. This is about 2 pounds. Then I'm going to add my pepper and onion. I'm going to mix that all together. Put the lid back on, check it every so often, cook it till that meat gets nice and brown. Just to see how it's doing. Starting to look pretty good. Meat's turning nice and brown. Vegetables are getting pretty soft. That's how we want it. Make sure you keep stirring it real good too. Make sure nothing gets burnt towards the bottom of the oven. So that's looking good there. Add some garlic powder. I'm gonna add some garlic salt, about a teaspoon. Add some regular salt. Some sea salt, about a teaspoon of that too. We're going to add our kidney beans. And I'm going to dump out about half of the juices first. It's Some people don't like beans in theirs, but I like it in mine. So we're gonna add those. We're gonna add about half of the juices too with that. Add 6 ounces of tomato paste. We're going to add our stewed tomatoes. This is 28 ounces. And our diced tomatoes. That's 28 ounces too. That pot's getting nice and filled up now. Now I'm going to add my chili powder. You want to put about a third of a cup in there. And add a little bit of cayenne pepper too, just to spice it up a little bit. About half a teaspoon, depending on how much you want. So now you want to stir this all together without overflowing it. Should have bought a bigger Dutch oven. I'm going to add some garlic, about 1 teaspoon of that. Minced chopped garlic. So now you want to mix that up real good. So get that nice and mixed up. And it is looking good. So I'm going to throw that cover back on. I'm going to let that sit for about half an hour or so. Build that fire up just a little bit more. And I cannot wait to eat this. I've been wanting chili for a long time now. Finally got around to making some. Now you don't have to have your fire blazing or anything. Just enough to heat that pot up, or that oven. Now, since this has beans in it, you want to make sure you stir it a lot. Just to make sure you don't burn any of them near the bottom of the oven. So just keep that moving in there. And you don't want any burnt beans in your chili. But as long as you keep them moving, you'll be good. Now, if you don't put any beans in your chili, you don't have to stir it quite as often. Where's my stick? All right, we're gonna stir this up again. Don't want to set your hot plate on the snow. It might cool it down too fast and crack it. I tend to almost forget that sometimes. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Smells good too. Wish you could smell it. Guess they don't have that feature on YouTube yet. I'm gonna put the lid back on just to keep all that good flavor in there. You always want to cook with the lid on. It's like I said, to keep that flavor locked in there. So I took this off the fire and I'm gonna let it sit here for about half an hour to 45 minutes. Let it simmer down. Let those flavors get all through there. And cleared out a little spot here for it. I didn't want to place it directly on the snow after being on the fire for so long. It might crack the oven going from hot to cold so fast. That is ready to go.